Good morning, girls. How are you all? I think all of you are safe and healthy. Stay home, stay safe. Okay. Today we are going to study computer networks paper. It is written by two authors, which is given in the picture. You can go through it. I have the PDF, ebook PDF of this particular paper. If you want, I will share it. Okay. Here I have given the first unit portion. There are four topics in this first unit. Among all the four topics, we are going to study only one topic, that is uses of computer networks, which is a very basic one. How the computer network is going to be used in different places. That's all. Okay, it is a very simple one. Then and there I have given the notes properly in the slide. You can go through it and you have to take a new notebook where you have to start writing your notes. Okay. Next, we are going to study the introduction to computer network. During the 18th century, there was a lot of mechanical systems was developed. So there was an industrial revolution. During the 19th century, steam engine was developed. And in the 20th century, we started gathering the informations and process that information, and that particular information was distributed among all the organizations. So we were in the need of sharing the informations, so that people have started inventing this computer network. So this computer network, what it will do, it will be interconnected together to share the informations. Like that, the computer network was introduced by using communication satellites and the internet. Now we are going to study the definition of the computer network. What is the definition? Already we have studied that set of the computers connected together. Okay, that is known as network. Here, why are we connecting together? To share the information, not only the information. You can share the resources, or you can share any kind of software, something. So it is commonly known as resources. So a network is nothing but two or more computers connected together. For what it has been connected? To share the resources. So this is the definition which is given there. If you are getting it in 2 marks, you have to write this definition only. Okay, you should not change the terms. The same term you have to use while you are writing the definition. Next one is the uses of computer networks. This is our topic now. How the computer network is going to be used in our daily life. Okay, first we are going to start this uses of the computer network in number of ways. Okay, so for example, many of the companies are using lot of computers. Why are they using computers? So there are some 8 uses I have given here. Each and every one I have explained in the slide clearly. So you can go through it. So first one is the resource sharing. Second one is the physical resources can be shared, and we can use VPN to share the informations, and you can use this network as a client server model. And the client server model can be used to send and also to receive the information. And commonly it can be used as the communication medium. And we can use it for electronic mail. And you can share your desktop with others to clarify your doubts or to explain your tools or something. The system can be shared with other person. These are all the uses of computer networks. In the previous slide, we have seen the list, right? Now we are going to see one by one in detail. First one is the resource sharing. What is this resource sharing? You can have the physical resources which can be shared with your friends, or it can be shared among the organizations. Either it can be a program or a resource or a device, it can be shared with the computers which is connected in the network. Next one is the sharing physical resources. this physical resources is nothing but printer, like that. A particular printer can be shared with all the systems which are connected in the network. Okay, if it is a LAN network, only one printer can be used to print the informations from all the computers. Okay, that is known as sharing physical resources. And next one is the VPN. VPN is nothing but the virtual private network, which can be used to join the individual networks at different sites. Okay, to extend the to the extended network. Next, client server model. The data are stored in a system is called as the server. The employers who is going to utilize those data are called clients. Clear? The fifth one is the client server model involves request and reply. If you see this client server model, you can look at the picture. Here in the picture, there is a client machine and also a server machine. The client will make a request to the server. For example, if we want to search anything, we will be called as the client, and the server which is going to provide the information, example, it can be a Google server. It is called as the server. So whatever request we are making will send to the server through the network. Once it is received, the server will process the request and it reply with a message through the network. This is called as client server model, which involves request and reply.